Hello friends, welcome to KK Java Tutorials. In this video tutorial, we'll talk about grep command in Linux. Grep command searches a file for a particular pattern of characters and displays all lines that contains that pattern. The pattern that is searched in a file is referred as a regular expression. So you can specify any regular expression to search any word or sentence in a particular file or more than one files. And that word or sentence we can search easily using a grep command, right? So to make this demo, I have already created few files on my desktop, and let me open the terminal by pressing Ctrl Alt T. Yeah, now I would like to move on the desktop. So right now I'm in my home directory, so let me move to the desktop. There my files are present. Yeah, so here I am going to show you how to make use of grep command. Yeah, so first of all, I am going to show you a very simplest grep command. So here I am going to write a grep, and here I am going to write that sentence or word which I would like to search in the particular file. So let's say I would like to search a binary. This is just a word, right? But it's not mean that always you have to mention a word here. You can specify a sentence in the double quotes as well. And after that, you have to specify the file name where you want to search. So here I have a file is called tutorials1.txt at my desktop. So if I press enter, then here you can see in this file, wherever this word is present, that is highlighted, right? Here you can see easily I can search. Now let me clear the terminal. Now here you can see searched text or search word I can see highlighted with a red color, but line number is not showing, right? So if you want to see the line number as well, then you have to specify some flag, and that flag is called minus n. Yeah, grep, then minus one, then search string, and then after you have to give the file name. If you press enter, then here you can see now it is showing the file line number as well where this word is present, right? So now let's move ahead. Now here we have seen how to search a given word in a particular file, right? So if you'd like to search any sentence in the specified file, that is also possible, right? So here I'm going to open this file, that's a tutorials.txt. And here I am going to copy one sentence that I would like to search. Yeah, so let's say I would like to search this sentence, right? Let me close this file. Now I would go over here and I will paste this sentence itself, right? And if I press enter, then here you can see file is this line is present, this text is, this sentence is present in the two different places, and this is the line number. We have specified this flag minus one because of that is showing the line number as well. Yeah, so here as of now we have seen how to search a word or sentence in given file, right? But sometimes if you would like to search basically given text or sentence in the more than one file, that is also possible using the wildcard, right? So here I'm going to write like grep command, grep, and then minus one, minus n, because I want to see the line number as well. Yeah, and after that, let's say I would like to search this sentence what I had copied, but this I would like to search in the more than one file, or you can say all the files, right? If you want to search in the all the files, just you have to put the asterisk. So I'm at desktop. Desktop is just a directory. In this directory, this sentence is going to search in all the files, right? So if I press enter, then you can see first column shows this is the name of the file, and second column shows line number where this sentence is present, right? So here I have two files, tutorials.1.txt and tutorials2.txt. So in second file, this line is present at one time, right? And which is at line number this, right? So in that way you can specify wildcard. So here wildcard can be specified in a different way. So here, instead of giving the asterisk, what you can do, you can give asterisk and dot txt. That means I would like to search this given search text in the only text file, and that will work perfectly fine. Apart from that, you can give the some partial name, something like this. Let's say I would like to search tuto, just partial name. After that, I don't care what is the file name, but that should start from tuto, and extension should be .txt, and that way also you can search. Yeah. Now one thing I would like to show you guys over here. So of course you can here what I have shown you wildcard, right? But here explicitly also you can give the file name, right? Let's say if you want to search into two files only, right? Then I will write tuto tutorial1.txt and similarly tuto tutorial2.txt, right? So you can specify the file name explicitly with a space, and this will work perfectly fine. Yeah. Apart from that, I would like to show you some flag as well, right? So here, let me clear the terminal. Some flag. So here I have shown you one of the flag is called minus n. Here let me show you some flag like let's say I write a grape minus n, and let's say I would like to search for binary, right? B-I-N-A-R-Y, binary, right? And file name I'm going to specify. Of course you can give the file name more than one, or we can use wild character. So just I would like to search in the tutorials once .txt, and word is called binary. So by default this search string would be in the case sensitive manner. This will search capital and small, that will understand in different way. So here you can see binary, which is in small, started with small b, all are in this part of the search. But if you want to ignore the case sensitivity, then you have a flag is called minus I, right? So simply you have to specify minus I, right? And here it will show you all the basically sentence binary, whether it starts from the capital B or a small b. Yeah, these things you have to keep in mind, but line number has gone, right? So if you want to, let me clear the terminal. So here instead I would like to see the line number as well, then this should work. So here you can see this is showing the line number as well. So N stands for line number, and I stands for case insensitive search. Yeah. Now let me clear the time. There are some more flags. I would like to give you some hint as well. So if you want to if you want to show all the lines that do not match the searched character, then simply you have to specify W flag, right? N for showing the line number, and W for you want to basically show all the lines that do not match the search string, means this as line where this search string is not present. For that you have a flag is called W, and in this case sorry guys, for invert selection it's not a W but it's V means invert. So this will give you the, all the lines where binary word is not available, right? Now let me clear the terminal and let me show you the some more flag. Apart from that, if you want to display only the count of the matching lines, then you can use the flag as C, right? C. So this will give you the how many times this binary is available in this tutorials 1.txt. Yeah. So that's all I wanted to show in this video tutorial, guys. So grab command is really important when especially when you try to debug some when you try to look into the some log files, and log file size is really huge, then grab is very important in that case to search any specific word or sentence, right? And sometimes you would like to see some pattern available in the multiple files, or some sentences available in the multiple files with the line number as well, right? So that's all I wanted to show in this video tutorial. Guys, big thank you for watching this video, and see you there in the next video tutorial.